Hello and welcome. In this video, we're going to talk about optimization in Genesys. We'll show you how to set up a network for optimization. We'll show you how to set the methods and goals, how to set optimized parameters. We'll review the results, and we'll show you how to do modeling through optimization. What's important in any RF or microwave tool is to have a robust optimizer. And what we plan to do here today as an example is to match 10 ohms to 50 ohms that you see a termination here in this ladder network at 10 ohms. And we have three equal L sections here of 10 nanohenries and 50 picofarads. Well, the first thing we want to do is then set up our simulation, and we'll take a linear simulation and we'll set the start and stop frequencies for 100, 200 megahertz, 101 points. So we have an octave wide band that we plan to optimize our network to. And if we look at the input return loss that we see here, you notice that it's not very good looking. It's minus 7 dB return loss to about minus 2 dB return loss. So it is not a very good match of 50 ohms as the circuit is. So our intent then is to select our parameters and then optimize those for the best match possible. What I'll do is draw a box around our components, and then from the schematic dialog, I'll select make all of them tunable. You notice they change colors to green, indicating that they're tunable, and they also indicated in our tune window. The next thing we want to do is to set up an optimization. So we'll add an optimization that brings up the optimization properties, and it also indicates the number of analyses. We can select one or more if we have more than one. We can select the optimization method. Normally we leave that at automatic, as well as the cost function, which is least squares in this case. Now for the goals, what we want to do is put a measurement in there, and it's derived from some data set, in this case the linear data set, and we're going to type in S11 because this is the goal that we're trying to minimize, or we want to try to minimize S11. You notice our options here to make it equal, less than, greater than, or percentage of our target. And our target in this case is going to be 20 dB. And we'll leave the weight at 1 since we only have one measurement to optimize. If we had two, we might have two different weights. Min and max relates to the frequencies over which you want to do your optimization. If you leave it blank, it actually defaults to the entire range. And now for variables, well, I might say here our initial cost is 162. For variables here, we can add or remove individual variables. We get our tuned variables here. You see there are six of them because we have six variables or components that are tunable. And then we can manipulate those in terms of min max values that we're allowed to optimize to. Under methods, again, we normally leave this in automatic, but it is a robust optimizer. It allows us to switch between different schemes, but automated settings usually work the best. If you want to check out these advanced settings, then just click on Help, and there's sections on using optimization, the cost function, and optimization methods that you can peruse and learn more about that. So we're going to select OK. You notice that there's on our graph that's turned bluish, and what I'm going to do is resize our graph. I'm going to take it off auto scale for the y-axis, and I'm going to make a minimum of, let's say, minus 30 dB and a maximum of 0 dB. And now we'll be able to see our goals, which is we're trying to achieve a return loss below that line. Okay. So we're ready to optimize. We can either optimize from the workspace tree, or we can do it from the little green arrow that you see here and click on optimization. And we start off right away. You notice the graph updates very quickly. You might also notice the error function as it decreases. And paying attention to that tells you how close you are to maybe your global minimum for an error function. In this case, it's continuing to drop, so I might be persuaded to just let it run a little bit longer. And as a result, obviously, we've met our goal that we have a 20 dB return loss across the entire band, which is pretty good, I think. What I'd like to show you now is another way to use optimization, and that is to build a circuit model that mimics some measured data. And in this case, we use this series LC network along with two parallel capacitors, and we're going to try to match it to this data set called some data. And here we see the S parameters for that data set. And if I press on frequency parameters, I can see it goes from 1 GHz to 5 GHz with 201 points. Caveat here is that we want to make sure our linear analysis covers the same range and number of points. So for the parallel capacitors, though, what we did is we attached that to the equations block. That is, since we're going to tune both at the same time. When we open that, we can see CP, which is that parallel capacitor, is set as a tunable variable, starts at 0.5 picofarads. And we've also established two equations. One here, ER1, for maybe error 1, and that equals the magnitude of the difference between the linear data set of S11 and the sum data set of S11, the measured data. So we're trying to minimize that difference, and that becomes ER1. ER2, likewise, is basically the same thing. We're minimizing the data, or at least S21, difference between the linear circuit data and our measured data. And there is our parallel capacitor there. Now, for optimization, I've already set one up, but if you remember, just from the, you can set up analysis from the drop-down window. Here is our analysis properties. We're going to obviously optimize around the linear analysis. We'll leave the optimization method and cost default values. And here are the measurements we're going to minimize. It comes from the equations block. First, ER1, and we set that equal to 0 because we want to minimize that to 0. When it's 0, then they're equal. And min and max we'll leave blank because we want to optimize over the entire frequency range. And likewise, we do the same for ER2. Notice our initial error is about 25. Now for the variables, we've selected our tune variables. We did this as we did before. If we wanted to add another variable, we could do that manually. But in this case, we'll just keep three tune variables that we started with. And the method we're going to leave automatic too, just as we did before. Now what I'm going to do here is tile the windows. We have a graph, a Smith chart, representing both S11 and S21, both from our circuit and our measured data. And you can see they're somewhat apart. The red should line up with the green and the blue with the red. So we're considerably off on our model. So the next thing we want to do is then optimize our circuit to the measured data. We can run the optimization, as you see here, from the menu or from the triangle. And we'll do that. And you note our error is continuing to decline. It started at 25, and now it's getting down fairly low, 0.3, 0.23, as you see here. But at some point, depending on how good our model is, we may only get to a certain level. That's our maybe global minimum, at least for the network that we are trying to model. So I think I'll stop it here at 0.23. And you'll notice that it does line up fairly well with our measured data. Let me update the graph. It's not perfect, but it's fairly good over the 1 to 5 GHz range. As I zoom in, you can see both magnitude and angle as they relate to each other. Now, you see that the values have changed considerably from their starting values, like a half a picofarad is down to 0.185 now. Some other thing I did is I added another graph, which is a graph of the error functions. And if you double-click on that, you can see the way I added the error function, since it's already defined in the equations block, all I have to do is type in equation and then ER1, or I can go to the measurement wizard. And you see here, you can add ER1, and again here, we can add ER2. So that might be very helpful for you to see where in the frequency range these errors occur. Well, I hope what I've shown you is how easy it is to use optimization in Genesys. Thank you.